by Michael Perry. The funerals have lately come one after the other. I had sworn an obituary moratorium, but when Great Aunt Mabel died last week, I knew I'd have to note it. I can't do justice to her 90 years other than to say, boy, she didn't waste any of them. Born up north, there in the township of Mage, near Sorona, she commuted to a one-room schoolhouse on wooden skis made by her father. When her school teacher ordered instruments from the Sears and Roebuck's catalog, Mabel and her three brothers formed a family band, and a love of music would be central to her life until the end. In fact, she met her husband Robert at a square dance in the Sorona Town Hall, and they danced until Farmer's Lung took him from the dance floor in the 1970s, and for good, in 1982. As a teenager, she spent summers thinning rutabagas and picking potato bugs in the same fields as German prisoners of war. She also helped on the home farm, where her chores included egg collection, a task she dreaded for all the pecking she endured. By way of revenge, for the rest of her life, every time she ate at a restaurant, she ordered chicken. My memories of Aunt Mabel are divided between my childhood, when she would fry up the fish we brought her, and the last decade or so, when she began showing up at public performances of mine with an octogenarian posse. Aunt Mabel, 80 years old and currently charging off to every cultural event within a 50-mile radius of Spooner, Wisconsin, usually a carload of restless contemporaries. They were something to see, this permed squad rolling up in a minivan with Mabel at the wheel, ready to encourage me during and razz me after. It was lovely to be made to feel like a kid at a school recital again in the very best way. Right through her final decade, she was really up for anything. When my brother asked if she wanted a ride in his two-seater airplane, he hadn't even finished the question before she headed for the cockpit, walking cast notwithstanding. Same when my brother-in-law offered her a ride on his ATV. Same when someone offered her a ride on a snowmobile. I share this so that when I tell you one of her dearest hobbies was sewing hot pads, you don't think she was just quietly willing her time away. It started with a few made as tokens of thanks for helpful friends. Then she began donating them for fundraisers, Christmas food baskets, and assisted living facilities. The week before she died, she finished hand sewing the border on her 8,000th pad. There was a stack of the final batch at the back of the church, and after the service, we were invited to help ourselves. Over time, Mabel's reputation grew so that people brought her all kinds of fabric prints from calico to comic. I chose a pair decorated with fire helmets for my firefighter pal Mills, John Deere logos for my collector neighbor Tom, and for my daughters, based on their favorites, one with cats and one with cowboy boots. This is just the thinnest gloss on a long, layered life, and a gloss over the stretches that weren't so blithe. But given this space, it will have to do. Words are not the true memorial, nor the headstone, but rather the casserole cooling on the quilted fabric, on Mabel's stitches neat and holding fast.